Hi, I'm Scott Hanselman, and it's Azure Friday. We're talking with David Ebbo about Azure Web Sites. We talked a little bit about logging. Let's get a little bit deeper into that. So yes. there's a trace listener that's handling that for me.
Uh-huh.
I can put it into Azure storage in a table.
Yes.
Blob sometime soon.
Right.
And or text files.
Or file system, yes, yes.
You had said, though, I could stream these logs somehow.
Yes, so that's an option that's interesting if you really want to see what your site is doing right now, as opposed to like doing analysis on what just happened, like you know, an hour ago.
Right.
So the way you do that is using the log streaming feature, which you can do in a number of ways.
Mm-hmm.
One of them is through Visual Studio that has support for that, and another one is the Azure command line, which is the one we'll be using now.
Okay, cool. And maybe we can try to get the Visual Studio one working later, right?
We could. Yes.
Who knows? We'll go right off script. So. This is from GitHub. This is this existing site, right?
Yes.
And it doesn't really matter what folder that we're in, but I know that the name of the site was this is from GitHub.
Yes.
So Azure site gives me some options. This is the command line. So we've got Azure site log. Azure site log. So I can download the file. Just directly?
Yes. Download would be similar to what we did over FTP, basically.
Okay. This is from GitHub. And
actually, this probably,
Azure site log download. Azure site log. This is from GitHub. We may have to do that again if we discovered a bug. Tail? Remind me to email.
That should work. Yeah.
Yeah, there's a bug, new bug.
It seems to be a bug, yeah.
So, Guang, I remember to email Guang.
Okay.
Azure, the regression.
So, the bug was
Azure
in the
Azure site log download.
That was the download function. Okay, the so tail, hopefully, it will work well.
Yeah. Oh, and then this is, we should do the, this is your app. We should just test this real quick since we're going to redo it again. So, app runs fine. If I remember correctly, we say Server Explorer.
Yes, Windows Azure and websites at the end. So I think the problem is, yeah, you need to import the subscription.
I thought we did that. Manage subscriptions? Oh, we didn't import the subscription ever.
I don't think we did, yes.
So I guess we'll do that live.
Yeah,
and just
sure.
See if it works. Okay, so we'll do download. We won't do download.
Okay.
Hi, I'm Scott Hanselman. It's Azure Friday. We're here with David Ebbo talking about Azure websites and specifically more about logging.
Yes.
In the last video, we saw that I could access the logs with FTP. We can put them in Azure storage. But you said something about streaming. How do I stream the logs?
Right. So streaming is interesting when you really want to see what your site is doing at this very moment.
Mm-hmm.
And the way to do that, so first of all, the log that we will see are the same that we were downloading over FTP.
Okay.
And there are two main ways that you can do that. One of them is via Visual Studio, and the other one is via the Azure command line tool.
Okay. Let's do the command line one first. So this is going to be doing the same login that we were doing before. We were saying trace.information, so we have sample this and that using the trace listener. I've gone into Azure, and I've turned those things on. Right now, we're on verbose. And the name of the website is this is from GitHub. So I come out here, and I'm using the Azure command line. This is the one you get from Node, the Node Package Manager. And this works regardless of whether you're using Node or not. This is just a great command line, and we'll have a whole series of videos on how to use this.
Yes, Node is really an implementation detail of this tool.
In fact, it is. So if I say Azure site, some of my choices are to start and stop the site. Here's log, Azure site log. So Azure site log, you can download the logs or tail. So that would be live.
Tail is the option for streaming, yes.
Okay. So tail, and then the name of the site is this is from GitHub. Executing. Okay, so you're now connected to the log streaming service.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so there's a back end somewhere that's listening here.
Right.
So I'll just put the DOS prompt over there, and I'll snap this over here, and I'll just hit refresh a couple of times. And as I'm doing that, go really fast. So that is actually live. I mean, it's coming in chunks, but it's coming in fast.
Right. There may be like a 0.3 second delay, but it's pretty fast. Yeah.
Okay. So I could even do like production. I could connect into production and really see what's happening.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Yes.
Very cool. What other kinds of command line options are there available? Like this, there's a lot of information. What if I want to see less? What if I just want to see?
Yeah, you can apply a filter to see a smaller number of lines.
So Azure Site Tail Filter. Maybe we'll just say the word error. Certainly, I could do that with log levels.
That would be the better way of doing it.
You know, maybe a better thing would be to say like, you know, oh my goodness, this is a bad error, or you know, hack, or whatever I've decided to put into my code. So here then I'm just seeing the things with the text error.
Mm-hmm.
In that case, that's just doing kind of an in string. I could go like that.
It's a simple string matching in this case.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And I remember when I FTP'd in, I saw there's the kudu deployment stuff, there's my application logs, but there's also the actual raw logs from IIS.
Yes. That's right.
This is a standard format, right? This is the standard IIS.
Yes, exactly the same as you would get in your local machine when running IIS.
Okay. Now, I've been saying site log tail to get that stuff. I can say dash P and look at the HTTP process.
That will now stream the IIS logs.
Now, these stream a little bit slower because of IIS?
Yes, that's right. I mean, even on your local machine, if you run the IIS and make requests, you won't see the log file updated right away. So the streaming kind of reflects the speed of IIS, which I think is typically under 30 seconds.
So I see. So what's happening is, there we go. So it's
that.
Buffering all of that stuff because IIS is focused on serving pages, not flushing
exactly.
The logs.
I mean, logging in general, tracing, you don't want that to slow down your app. So.
Right. And here I'm also seeing a lot of information.
Yes.
I mean, I'm getting.
But that's really the standard IIS format is because, you know, lines are wrapping, so there's lots of fields.
Right.
Yeah.
And the logs are still being put into that folder in FTP, so I can get them later.
Yes.
Okay.
Potentially Azure Storage as well, if you had that set up.
Mm-hmm. Now, how would I see this from Visual Studio? This is the same application in Visual Studio, and I've installed the Azure tools here in the server.
Yes. So one thing we have not done here is we need to import the subscription. Right now, it doesn't know who you are.
Okay. So I will right-click and say Import Subscriptions.
Yes.
And it's saying, go get my subscription. I could say download and get that subscription. I think I put that in my downloads folder, in fact. So there's my subscription file. I probably shouldn't have saved that. I'll delete it when we're done.
You're supposed
to
delete it when you're done, yes.
Yeah. Okay, so I just did that. It's saying websites refreshing right here. So it must have figured out that I'm really me. It looks like I can also manage those subscriptions.
Yes.
Do you see I have an MSDN and I have my 3-month trial? And
that's right.
Like
you need to make sure you pick the right one that matches the site that you're using right now.
Ah, okay.
Because when you do the download, that's actually not for one subscription, but it has the information about all of your subscriptions.
Right.
So
in fact, I did get all of my subscriptions, but the one that we're working on is called, this is from GitHub.
Yes.
So from here, I can start and stop it.
Yes.
And view streaming logs.
Yes, and you'll basically get exactly the same thing as you got from the command line, but from the VS window.
So now we're connected to the same service.
Mm-hmm.
We'll come back over here. And I hit refresh, and I'm getting the same experience. This time I'm inside of VS.
Yes.
Which is real nice, because now I can go and actually change my my home controller if I wanted to, and then go and deploy and then see the changes.
Yes. I mean, the goal here is that the experience is very similar to what you would get if you were to just run the site locally and go in output.
Right.
You would get this, and now you get it from what's going on in Azure.
Very cool. I can certainly go and stop that then, go and see which logs that I care about, download them if I wanted to, and then similar filtering. So in this case, I could also say, give me the web server logs or everything.
Similar options to what we had on the command line, but there's a UI. It's, you know, some people prefer one, some prefer the other.
Very cool. So that's logs in Azure and Azure websites. It's Azure Friday.